Okay, well, here we are. Ryan really didn't want me to make these, but I think we're really onto something. I had the fluorator on my dog's head the other night, and he acted like he knew what I was thinking. At least, it kind of seemed that way, I don't know. George and Paul still don't want to test on a person, but Ryan seems really adamant. He wants to put it on himself, I don't know why. I guess he's always kind of been that way, though.
Dude, you can't go. It's me first.
Okay.
No, dude, like, you have to go.
It's like an L.
Yeah, like no, one to the side. No, like one to the side, then two, like kind
of
the side.
Nice of you to start without me.
Oh, sorry, Ryan. I didn't know you were coming.
Why wouldn't I be?
It's just, you don't usually show up to our non-required meetings.
Yeah, but I've been making serious progress with this, and I don't want you three to mess it up. What's with the, camera?
Oh, I was just looking at it.
So it's done?
Not yet. We haven't done enough tests of the eye ray's effect on the human brain. We need to be sure it's safe before someone puts it on, or it could cause memory loss or... Stop, don't press that. Paralysis or worse.
Fear's for chumps, Rosie. Grow a backbone.
Did you end up testing it on your dog?
You tested it on your dog? What about what you literally just said to me?
I did, but it was weird. It seemed like it worked, but it kind of made me feel like we're delving too deep into some stuff. Like, maybe there's things that even science shouldn't explore.
Oh, Rosie, there's nothing science shouldn't explore.
Yeah, Eureka and whatnot.
Yeah, I guess.
Hey, Rosie, I'm talking to you. Your dog? You tested it on your dog?
Yes, I did a tiny test for less than 2 seconds, okay? That doesn't mean it's safe for a person. It's impossible to know how our higher brain function would respond.
Whatever, man.
What's the issue, Ryan?
Nothing, George. You guys just keep living your happy lives while I sit here doing nothing, being no one.
What happy lives are you referring to, Ryan? You barely know us.
I know you enough, Paul. Your rich parents practically setting you up for a career in law. And what about you, George? You barely passed grade 9, and yet you're in line for a scholarship to Princeton just because of your mother's academic success. And you, little Rosie, you think you're in charge of this group because what? You had the idea? You spend your days looking down on everyone around you.
Maybe we shouldn't do this today.
Yeah, I'm going home.
No, guys, wait!
You know what? Just screw you, you cowards.
Ryan, no!
I didn't know.
What did you see?
I saw you. I felt everything. Your machine, it worked.
What?
It worked, Rosie. It worked. I can see what you guys feel.
What do you mean?
George, I know that deep down you know you shouldn't do science, and that's not a bad thing. You're an excellent writer. Everyone at school knows that. Why aren't you trying to go to a school for writing?
What if my parents think I'm a failure? Who wants a writer as a son?
I think that your parents should be a lot prouder of you for something you actively choose to do rather than something you feel obligated to do. And Paul.
Yeah?
Don't go to law school.
Why not?
Your parents will understand that if you just talk to them. I know that they'll understand. You see,
I never really had many friends. And I don't know, and I feel like now I feel like I understand. Rosie, your invention worked. You're not useless. You're a genius. It worked.
I think we should destroy this thing once and for all.
What?
Yeah, she's right. Yeah, there's some stuff that science is just too personal to explore.
Yeah, I think from now on, I'm just gonna stick to honest conversation.